So lads, what's the best thing about being down under?
I just love the people here. The people, it reminds me a lot on Ireland. Everyone's got the same sort of mentality. They've got the same humour, which makes life a lot easier. And it's like Ireland in the sunshine. And the people here just seem to love our music, which is great and much appreciated. And the last tour we done, it was a Celtic arena tour, and we only got released here a year before, so it was amazing. It's just different for us because we've been touring America and Canada for so long. I'm a very keen surfer and fish, and I live on a boat back home, or I live in LA on a boat, so I love being out in the sunshine and love being in the water, and the beauty of being in Australia is a lot of the places are on the coast, so I brought my surfboard with me this time and I'm hoping to catch a few waves.
On a personal note, I think what I love about Australia is I've got family here. My dad's sister, my aunt and my uncle came out here on a boat over 40 years ago. It took them 6 weeks, I think, on the boat to come from Ireland to here. And they emigrated not knowing what Australia was having in store for them, you know. And it's been great just to go and visit them as part of the show, and they to come and see the show and meet some extended family I've never actually met before.
I'm looking forward to seeing places we didn't see on the last tour. Actually, we've more shows this year, which is great news. It shows that the music is really growing down here, and we're playing more and more gigs and places like Cairns we haven't seen before, and other places, and definitely getting outdoors and enjoying some of the activities that are available down here that we wouldn't get to do when we're usually at home.
The people in Australia have just been so friendly. They've been so welcoming to us, and it's a pleasure to come down here and get a chance to do the tour. And you know, we must be the most fortunate guys in the world who actually have jobs like this. We're all loving singing, we all love what we do, and we've got a chance to see the rest of the world doing it. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
We have just shot a very new show, Mythology, and that's what's going to be coming out next and going to be our new show. So a lot of what we're doing in this tour, we're actually saying goodbye to a lot of the songs that we've been singing for the last 5 years. It's almost like saying goodbye to old friends sort of thing, you know. And so it's like a greatest hits tour. That's what this is going to be. So maybe the last time we will sing them again. So that's why it's going to be special, and that's right. Well, part of it. So I'm tearing up here, so.
Boys are back in town.
Melbourne show that we played here last year, I remember it was one of the biggest gigs we had done. It was like 5,500 people, and the place was packed and the atmosphere was amazing. But also I had family that live in Melbourne came to the show, and my parents had flown especially from Ireland to see the show as well. And definitely for me, I remember every detail about that night. It really was special.
When you're coming down to start playing in a brand new land, you're coming down to try and maybe win people over, you know. But I'll always remember being backstage and hearing them stamping their feet. The whole place had erupted, you know, just before we had gone on. It was just like, geez, the lads were preaching to the converted here, you know. These all loved this already. So it was just an incredible atmosphere, settled us straight into the tour, and we never looked back, you know.
I loved the gig on the Gold Coast last year. I've got lots of friends that live in the Gold Coast. They're almost like extended family at this stage. And the reason why I remember it too is because I fell coming off the stage and I could hear half the crowd laughing at me, which was all my friends, which made the show even more memorable. But yeah, the Gold Coast was a good hit.
I think a few guys were laughing when he fell off the stage as well. Not just the people in the front.
The only way I can describe it was like Bambi on ice.
We've got so much to be thankful for being members of Celtic Thunder and what it's done. You know, I know the alternative. I used to be a chartered accountant.
I'd been singing in bars and clubs in Scotland for the last 20 years, and I think, like anybody who is a singer, if they're playing the guitar, they're always trying to take their trade or their craft to a higher level. And I thought, you know, after so many years of playing in the circuit in Scotland, I'd sort of missed the boat, and I would never have the opportunity to take it to a new level. And then when Celtic Thunder came along, and I went for the auditions, myself and Keith and Ryan, of course, as the original members of the group.
With the honesty that you see on stage, this is what you don't see off stage.
Yeah. Yes. This is about to get nasty.
Yeah, of course.
There's a song, 500 Miles, which I didn't know how globally famous that song was. And I think as soon as you hear the first couple of chords getting played in the song, everybody's behind the song. And you know, they want to get up there and just join in with the whole song. And I think that had the biggest sort of crowd feedback for myself when I was singing.
So, what can the audience expect from a Celtic Thunder performance? Well, you're definitely going to see us five, anyway.
I hope so.
That's a guarantee. Well, they can expect a night of loads of fun, loads of music. There's a lot more to our shows than just us guys going out singing songs. There's a whole spectacle to the show as well. We carry around a massive stage and set with us, and we've a live band on stage who are very talented musicians, and we've dancers who show a bit of Irish dancing, and not just Irish music, you know, all different spectrums of music. You've loads of songs that they're going to know, and as well as that, loads of original songs that are unique to Celtic Thunder.
I think honesty is the best thing that comes across on stage, and when you come to see us guys, you're going to have a good time, because us guys do pour our hearts out on stage, and we give it everything we've got, and when you see us laughing and with the crowd, we're genuinely laughing and we're being genuine.
It's almost as if, you know, we want you to imagine that you're, when you're in the audience, that you're actually sitting in our local pub and listening to us playing or singing along. And Celtic music is all about storytelling. We want to tell you the story. When I sit in a seat, I want someone to lift me out of the seat, swing me around the theatre for the next 2.5 hours, and then drop me back down and sit at the end of the show, and then you know you've had a good show and you've had a good experience, and that's what we're trying to do with every Celtic Thunder show.
A voice ever calling.